Welcome again. Thanks for joining me this morning. This morning, we're going to be talking from the book of Joshua 1. And it says, now Jericho stretching up because of the children of Israel. None went out and none came in. Joshua's generation knew that God has promised them the land of Jericho. But they were ready to fight for it. They were not afraid to fight for what God has promised them. They were not scared to enforce the provision that heaven has made for them. They understood that though they needed to fight to possess their possession, they understand that God made a promise to them to fight for what is theirs, to fight for what belongs to them, to possess the land, to fight the battle so that they can possess the land that God has promised them. Friends, your wealthy place may not become a reality this year if you just sit back waiting for things to fall into places. Fight to possess the wealthy place. Fight between any opposition standing between you and God's promises for you. Wage war against any plan of the enemy that is standing between the God's promises for you and your destiny, between God's promises for you and every riches that God has promised you this year. Fight the battle that will help you to possess the position that the heaven has made available for you this year. Joshua's generation fought the battle unto their brethren from the other tribe, possessed their own possession. God says, pray unto the chain and boundary, holding down your generation is broken down. Pray unto things fall into places for you this year. Jericho was not vacant when Joshua and his people went to possess the land. Some people were occupying the land God promised them. There might be people occupying the place that God has promised you. Some people may be contesting against the level that God has promised you this year. You need to pray and wage war against those people to possess your land, to possess what belongs to you. Matthew 11:12 says, from the day of the John the Baptist, the kingdom of God suffered violence. Only the violent take it by force. Declare with me today, I will fight for my land. I will possess my possession that the Lord has promised me this year 2017. As you do so, friends, the devil has no choice than to give way. As you possess the land that God has given you this 2017, the devil has no choice to move away. This 2017 is a year of your next level. We must move from the old level to a new level. We must achieve our goal this year. All the things that has been stopping us, has been blocking the promised land that the Lord has given us, is enough. This 2017 is our year of next level. And as you do so, as you move to the next level, you will be surprised what the Lord will do. The Lord will fight your battle for you. The land that belongs to you, that the Lord has given to you, the possession that the Lord has given to you, the blessing that the Lord has given to you, the wealth that the Lord has given to you, you will possess them in this 2017. But you know what? You can't just sit back and wait. You've got to fight your battle. You've got to wage the war in prayers this year. This year is not a year to sit back and wait for things to happen. This is a year to move forward. This is a year to take everything by force. This is a year to fight our battle. This is a year to move to the next level. And I pray with you this morning, as you move forward, as you fight, as you wage war in prayer against the principality and the power of the enemy standing and stopping you from achieving the God's plan, and the Lord will give you the strength to move forward. The Lord will strengthen you. It will give you the power that you need to go to the next level. Every obstacles on your way, I declare to you this morning, I come against them right now in the name of Jesus. I prophesy into your life right now as you're looking at me. I say this year will be a year of next level for you. In your academic, it will be a year of next level for you. In your business, it will be a year of next level for you. In your marriage, it will be a year of next level for you. With your children, it will be a year of next level for you. At your working place, it will be a year of next level for you. But before you can be a partaker of this, you need to acknowledge Jesus Christ as the Lord and Savior. You need to realize at the mention of the name of Jesus Christ, every knee must bow and every tongue must confess that Jesus is Lord. I love you so much. God bless you. Let's work together this year so we can get to our next level. See you next week. God bless you. Love you.